Imagine that you could create your own custom music tracks in minutes without any musical expertise. With Udio AI, it's not just possible, it's actually easy. You can pull together all types of tracks like these. In this video, we'll walk through how to use Udio, one of the most popular AI music generators. And best of all, it's completely free to use. Let's dive in. To get Udio, head to udio.com. You can click on the link in the top right-hand corner, and I've also included a link in the description below. Here we are on the Udio homepage. Before we can create any music, we have to create an account. To do that, go over to the top right-hand corner to the sign up button. Click on it. On this page, sign up, and I'll see you on the other side. During the sign up process, you'll see this page, and this shows you the three plans that you can choose, from free, standard, to pro. For this video, I'm going to go with the free plan. This plan allows you to have 10 songs per day. Later on, we'll also check out some of the features in the standard plan. Now that you've selected the free plan, you're going to come to a page where you can create your songs. Up above is where you can describe the song that you want to create. Try to be as descriptive as you can. That usually leads to better results. I think I would like AI to write a jingle for my business, Steven Studio Sessions. Once you're happy with your description, you could click on this pink button down here. Now that the AI has finished generating, you'll notice that you get two songs in the upper right-hand corner. To play the song, click on the image.
Steven Studio Sessions, come on by, oh, where melodies and magic.
Look at that, you made your first AI song. Let me know in the comments what you thought of yours. As we listen to the songs, you might have noticed that both of the genres were pop. In my description, I didn't include a genre, so the AI randomly selected it. If you want a genre, make sure you include that in your description. Otherwise, AI will create one for you. You might have noticed that the songs have lyrics. If you want to check them out, click on the title of your song, and the lyrics will be down here in the lower portion. I'm going to go back to my creations now. Listening back to the songs, I thought they were pretty good, but they're not quite what I'm looking for. So this time around, I'm going to add a little bit more to my song's description. Here, I start out with the genre, and then I continue on with my description. Now that I've completed my description, we're going to look at more of the features. You'll notice down below, we have upload audio, and next to it, we have a crown, and that means that it's part of the standard plan. We'll look at that later. Down below, we have a lyrics option. Right now, it's currently set to auto-generated, which means AI will just create the lyrics. Next to that, we can write our own lyrics. And next to that, we can go for the instrumental option without any lyrics. I'm going to go with write lyrics. Now we have two options. Up here, AI is going to ask us what our song is about, and we can write that in here, and it'll generate a sample for us. If we don't like it, we can hit this regenerate button. And down below that, we can write in our own lyrics. I think I'm going to go with that option. Now that I pasted in my lyrics, I've included song structure components like verse and chorus in the lyrics to clearly organize the sections of the song. This lets Udio understand the structure. In addition, by pressing the forward slash on my keyboard, I can access some other structural components, for example, the bridge, the hook, and if we go all the way to the bottom, we could even see spoken word. But for my song, I don't think I'm going to need any of those. I'm just going to stick with verse and chorus. So that's all I need for now. At the very bottom, we also have some advanced controls. When I open this, you can adjust the length of the song, for example, 2 minutes, or just 32 seconds. You can also select the model that you would like, but I'll stick with the most advanced model right now. I think I'm good with everything else, so let's click on Create. Now that the songs have generated, I'm going to take a quick listen to each one to see which one I like better. That has a lot of power to it. Let me go to the next one. You know what? I think that one has an upbeat feeling to it. So I'm going to go with Euphoria Awaits. But I think it needs an intro. So now I'll show you how to add that. Move the mouse over to this button that says Extend and click on it. Here we are on the Extend page. And in this part of the page, we have four options. We can add an intro. We can add a section before. We can add a section after. Or we can add an outro. I'm going to go with an intro, like I said before. So I'll click right here on this circle. For my intro, I don't want any lyrics. So I'm going to scroll down a little bit. And here where you see lyrics, you can either write lyrics, you can have them auto-generated, or instrumental. And so for my intro, I just want an instrumental. So I'm going to click right here. At the very top, we can now click on Extend. And that will generate some new tracks for us. Now that the songs have been extended, you'll see in the titles that you see EXTV1 and then here EXTV2. That shows you that the song has been extended. Also, notice that the time has been increased to 1 minute and 5 seconds. Now that you've extended the song, you can download it as a WAV or MP3 file by clicking on these three dots and then going over here to download. Along with downloading, you also have a lot of other options such as remixing, editing, trimming, and if you don't like the way the song sounds, you can even delete it right down here. You might have noticed that my songs are starting to accumulate, but I need some way of staying organized, and I use folders to do that. So I'll show you how to do that. Go over to New Folder right up here. Since I selected Euphoria Awaits, I'm gonna type that in and hit submit. You'll notice that the folder has been created. Right now I'm inside the Euphoria Awaits folder, but I need to get out of it. So I'm gonna click on this home button and that'll take me to the main area where all the songs are. If I wanna move the songs to that folder, let's say here, like Euphoria Awaits, I'll click right there on the checkbox. And once I've selected all the songs that have to do with Euphoria Awaits, a window will pop up down here and I can either add to a playlist or I can move to a folder. And I want to move to a folder, so I'll click on this button right here. And then I'll click on there. And that'll send the folders to the tracks. Now that we've looked at all the free capabilities, let's take a look at what you can do with the paid plans. One of my favorite things to do is to bring my own melodies into Udio. So if I have an MP3 of a melody that I've created or a wave, I could just drag it into Udio and then Udio will generate some songs for me. So let me show you how to do that now. And if you're interested in learning how to create your own melodies in MP3 and WAV formats, but you don't know where to start, you can check out my FL Studio Beginners tutorial. So just click on the link in the description below to watch. Once you have your WAV file, there are two ways to upload it. You could click on this button, Upload Audio, or you could just simply drag it over this area. That's what I'm gonna do. You'll notice that a screen comes up, drop an audio file here to upload and generate music. They have a variety of formats. They even have MOV or .mp3, .mp4. I'm gonna go with .wav. Now you have another screen that says confirmation by uploading this file. You have you attest that you have the right to use and distribute this file. I'll click on the I understand and confirm since this is a melody that I have created. And then I'll click confirm. Here we are on the extend page, and that's because we're extending the melody that we gave Udio. Right up here, we can see that the song has successfully been uploaded. And next to that, all we have to do is add a description. I'm going to include the description that we used earlier. Now, all I have to do is click this extend button. Now the songs are ready. So I'm going to show you my melody and then what AI did with it. So that was my melody. And now if I forward a little bit, you can hear what AI did with it.
Steam in the studio. The lights are glowing. The beat is pumping. Creative flowing. Synths and rhythms. They collide and race.
Now that I've listened to it, I don't really think that's right for the theme. So I have a couple of options. I can see what the next one sounds like, or I can just keep extending the melody until I find one that I like. One feature I really like is to be able to download individual instruments, which you can later bring into your FL Studio or Ableton. So to do that, you'll click on these three dots and click on download. In this view, you'll see the file type, video, but we want to get the stems. So it's number four on the list. And here you have your vocal stems, you have your drum stem, bass stem, other stems. Or if you want to download them all together, you can just click on this download all button. And that's Udio AI. Now you can make your own songs. Try it out for free and let me know what you think in the comments. See you in the next one. Or I'll hear your next song on the dance floor.